surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me. Come on a safari with me.
Early in the morning we'll be starting out. Some honeys will be coming along. We're loading up our hoodie with the boards inside and heading out singing our song.
Come on. Final land. Over there. Put that little pedal in there. Do not hit her with that. No. Over here. There's two over here. Blow the gum out. Okay. Brad. Future gardeners of America. And all you kids, I can tell, are so excited to be here. Could you wait for me? Hey, dude. We're in there, okay? So today, we are going to learn why corrugated drainage pipe is your friend. Well, yeah, Mary, this is the pipe that nasty, sludgy, stinky things go through. Yes, that's correct. Why is it shaped like your grandfather's colon? Hey, I did a colonoscopy on your grandfather. This is not shaped like his colon. He's got big diverticuli all over him, so I don't think it is. So just don't worry about it. But why is gardening pipe, drainage pipe, why is it your friend? Wait. Y'all are leaving? What do you mean you didn't have to come anyway? Ice cream in the cafeteria. Oh, God, you did it again. Undermined my whole thing. The administration just does not care about gardening. They don't care. All they're concerned about is the kids. You know. I will have my revenge. Corrugated drainage pipe will be taught in this school. It will be mandated by the school board. Okay, so now that I got that out of the way, are all the children happy? My grandkids, my two imaginary friends at home. Let's see if I've got them on monitor over here. Chicago, there he is. Peking, dude, comb your hair. Looking kind of goobery there. So all of the frivolity out of the way, I'm sure we'll have no more frivolity on this show. Why is this stuff really good for a garden? Well, I've used this probably for 30 years for different things, the most obvious of which is drainage. But when you have an area that you're wanting to control nutrients and composting delivery, as well as water, these things are excellent. And so what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you how to reorient your garden around these little miracles of modern science that look like the robot arms on Smith Family Robinson's Lost in Space. And for all the young people watching, they're going, what? Or they're thinking about this series. Don't you remember? Danger, Will Robinson, danger! Danger, Will Robinson! And that really creepy, like, ne'er-do-well Dr. Smith. And I'll give you the overview, and then I will do a time-lapse cut-up, because I hate to see people do menial tasks for a long time. But this pipe we use to deliver our compost, you know, as well as water, when it's dry or when plants are needing the extra water. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to come into this thing that will go in the ground, and I'm going to drill holes all the way through here that allow for liquids to come in, go out, and worms to come in. And then I'm going to drill those holes up as deeply as I want it, as deeply as I want it in the ground. And that will be, I'm not going to tell you how far, wait, hold up, let me measure. Let me get this out and really do, no measuring. Measuring is a no-no on this show. Too analytical and too specific. But depending on the ground that you're in, it'll either go low or it can go as deep as you want it to. Like in some of our beds, we're only sinking it probably 6-8 inches deep, something like that. And in some of our other beds that require like heavy water, heavy feeding, you know, we probably will dig holes up, you know, 12 inches. And then the other issue is how much above it do you leave without holes? And why do you leave without holes? Well, I mean, it's simple. If you want to water deeply, all you have to do is fill this with water with the holes at the bottom, and you customize your holes, okay? I mean, if you want a fast water watering deep, and you can put it as deep as you want it. You know, if you put it like into the really deep, like let's say 10, 12 inches down, if you put it down there, the roots are gonna seek it, you know? So it should develop, and I'm gonna study this later. This is an experiment. It in theory should stimulate some really remarkable root growth. So you dig holes as deeply as you want your nutrients to go and your water, and then you leave so much above the ground, which will make your water column, which will provide the pressure to force the nutrients and the water out of your holes that are in the ground. And once again, you can either drill a lot of smaller holes, but make sure they're large enough for earthworms to come into, because you want the earthworms to really come in and out of those things. So I'll let you all customize that and play with that. And the height of this, except for ease, because if this is really low, it's hard to pour your nutrients into this. And when I say nutrients, I'll tell you what we do in a minute. So I'll leave that up to you too. This is what we're putting in now. I guess this is probably almost 4 feet. That may actually be a little long. So I'm going to cut these up in a second, but the way we do our compost is when we're in the kitchen, we have scraps or whatever. We put them in our compost bin, but then we get them in a dedicated vitamix, or I think it's not something to the end, actually, 34,000 revolutions a second, and blend it into this compost soup, which we pour in here. So that's a really nice, non-messy, non-stinky, one-step way to compost all of your kitchen scraps, pretty much. I don't put the obvious stuff in, like citrus and things like that. I'm going to assume you guys probably got more composting knowledge than I do. And I say this on every show, okay? First of all, Dennis Miller principle. This is just my opinion. I could be wrong.
Of course, that's just my opinion. I could be wrong.
Second thing is, I'm not an expert. I mean, I've done this my whole life. I've like, you know, when did I start gardening? I mean, I've been easily doing this 45, 50 years. So when you've made as many mistakes as I have, you learn some stuff. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and cut these things up, and you guys can watch or not watch, I'll timestamp it, and then we'll go put one in the garden and show you how it works. Nice.
Time, folks, so hurry, hurry, hurry. Step right over to our refreshment center for the most extravagant array of refreshment goodies ever assembled under one roof. Enjoy breathtaking, mouth-watering goodies, everything from a snack to a delicious full meal. At our refreshment center, you'll find a large variety of goodies to satisfy your hunger, your thirst, or your sweet tooth. So hurry, hurry, hurry. Visit our refreshment center now. The show starts in 5 minutes. The show starts in 4 minutes. The show starts in 3 minutes. The show starts in 2 minutes. The show starts in 1 minute. And now, on with the show.
Shoes and I just drank my last two shots of booze and I ain't got enough money to pay my rent. Well, the federales have took my truck and now I'm down to my last 20 bucks and I just can't take it anymore. Well, I know that this life can get you down, down, down. So Harvey, can't you beat on the ground, oh Lord? And I try. I try to just get by, 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 but I just can't take it anymore. Well, I met Chuck Norris in the alleyway. Well, he punched me in the face and he ran away. Picked up my dog and kicked him off the bridge. Well, I picked myself up and I kept on going, but I lost my coat and now it's snowing and I just can't take it anymore. Well, I know that this life can get you down, down, down. So hard to get your feet on the ground, oh Lord. And I try. I try to just get by, 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 but I just can't take it anymore. Well, I smoked my last bowl and now it's gone. I guess I'll have to sniff the resin out from my bong and just sit my ass on the couch and just try to get high. Well, I tried to light my lighter, but it won't work. I tried to light it with my toaster, but my fingers burned. And now I just can't take it anymore. Well, I know this life can get you down, down, down. So hard to get your feet on the ground, oh Lord. And I try to just get by, 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 but I
just can't take it anymore. Well, I know this life can get you down, down, down. So hard to get your feet on the ground, oh Lord. And I try to just get by, by, by. But I just can't take it anymore. No, I just can't take it anymore.
Got a little nutty with the Sufu crew. We had a lot of fun with you. I bet our soul we're from the beautiful sun. It's a close cousin story, has just begun. It went up the rum, never flow, never back down. Rolled around, triple X campground. The rain came pumping down like a fountain. And I lost my mind up on Candy Mountain. Dance at the soup pass ranch with the festivus pole that was made from a branch. There's poppers in the ships and trips, oh my, what's happened to me?
Well, I think it was that one guy.
You only come home 3 times a year, so if you're in the trap, you're gonna find us. Yeah, we got the Kush and the diesel, northern lights, but nothing tastes sweeter than the summer nights. So, well, come on down, take a look around, slap another bag of wine. Cause the grass is greener, every's greener, and there's not a cloud in the sky. Well, come gather round and listen to the sound of 1,000 dirty bare feet hitting the ground. To everybody on the bus, we're going down to the Midwest psychedelic front porch showdown. Down from the North Pole, I asked him for some green, but he gave me some coal. He said, well, maybe you can smoke it if you put it in your bowl. That's the last time I'll ever ride to that asshole.
Well, I got the coal if you got the bowl, and if you're down with it, it's a one-hit quit.
I took one hit of coal and the room started turning. But next year I'm gonna keep the fireplace burning. The back to reality, we don't wear shoes. No matter Mississippi, we only tip the canoe. Rock the porch, you get stoned like a boulder. Rock the boat, but don't tip the boat over. If we leave right now, we can make it home, baby. This time tomorrow, I can see my old lady. It's a beautiful day under the big blue dome. Back on the bus and take the long way home. Everybody on the bus, everybody on the bus,
everybody on the bus now.
Everybody on the bus, everybody on the bus,
everybody on the bus.
We're going down to the Midwest psychedelic rodeo showdown. Come on down, take a look around, slap another bag of wine. Cause the grass is greener, air is cleaner, and there's not a cloud in the sky. We're going to find your place, let's get lost in space like a June bug in July. Everybody on the bus, we're going down to the Midwest psychedelic rock port showdown.
We love you guys. We'll see you out there.
You with irritable stomachs or irritable bowels, you may not want to watch this. I'm just joking. It's not that bad. So this is what this video is supposed to all be about. Okay, so as I said, this is what we do with pretty much all of our kitchen scraps now. And I've simplified the process. It's a little messier than this, as you might expect. But, I mean, you typically end up with some type of compost. It's normally a little chunkier. And we just put it in the, we just put it in the wearing and, you know, make sure it's liquid enough. And then turn it on. Deliver it into something.
So I'm just going to walk down our beds, and here's some of the totally tubular things that we placed. So this is more of a ground view of it. So in this one, we have about 12 inches below, and probably, let's call it 12. So that's 2 feet. So that's a foot of hydrostatic pressure pushing things out, nutrients, water, all the things we talked about, into this area. And we're developing, and I'll show you how we use it functionally. You know, asparagus are heavy feeders, and I'm going to be doing a show specifically to show you how to integrate heavy the watering and feeding characteristics of plants and group them together along with companion planting with different kinds of herbs and flowers to retard the pests. So all of that's kind of a unit for us, but it's hard to take it all in one bite. So I'm snipping it off for you and trying to make it palatable.
Yeah, real palatable.
So there is another two. So hence the reason for the height. These are okay. I actually think I should have made them a little higher, and I'm probably going to replace the ones in the asparagus garden, because, you know, asparagus, corn, here's our ginger that died off, so we'll come back in and get that in the spring, maybe take a little bit this fall. But you see, we have the pipes all the way down, and we center our planting around the pipe, okay? And sometimes we'll include the Three Sisters method. That's going to be another show about mounding and probably the earliest companion planting. There'll be another show on how to use trellising. You see all that down at the end. But these are all tied together. I had great tarragon this year. So there it is. Now let's see what it actually looks like. So there's what a tube in place looks like. I'm going to go ahead and install the compost for the last few days. And we mixed this a little firm. Actually, I should have mixed it up. And sometimes if you spill on the outside, that's fine. It'll just compost out here. Well, what we do is we come behind it now with a hose and just fill the tube with water. And so if you see down here, I don't know if you can see or not, but down in the tube, you see the compost there at the bottom. By tomorrow, that will probably be gone, but maybe not, because the other factor we take into account when we do this is what consistency to make the compost. So if it's a heavier consistency like that, it's going to take it a little bit longer, you know, to go into the soil and have the worms work it into the soil. So the upcoming, and that's it. If you want the cliff notes, corrugated pipe, cut it to some length, drill a few holes, and start your watering and your nutrient new way of doing things around the pipe. It's totally tubular. Dum 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 d
out what's dirt. Put on table, the legs sticking up, she got to table, I'm gold.
For the two of you that are still viewing out there, and that's only because you're at a frat party and you're too drunk to turn anything else on. Keep viewing. It's almost over. Yay, you survived. Running Man 4. So,
I'll be back.
This is going to be an interesting experiment in and of itself. Kind of a social experiment. To see whether anybody is actually going to buy in to this level of integration and fact finding. We'll see. I don't know. I consider this really your station more than mine. I'm going to come up with some stuff. I've got questions I want answered. But one of my selfish reasons for wanting to do this was I love talking to people that know more than I do. It's not hard to talk to them all day, every day, don't you? What? I'm going to learn a ton from you guys. Not only from the questions, but just from what you share. You know, I plan on doing a listener segment or whatever you call it every week. And you're just going to have to take this for what it is. I'm 62 years old, you know. When I grew up, we were still using the abacus. Well, not far from that. Maybe abacus too. You know, had a higher microprocessor, had slicker tines on it, you know, more grip on those little balls. Wow, man, when they came out with the rubberized ones, oh, man, you're talking about speed. So, that's a perfect example. You have no idea what's going to happen. Neither do I. That's why they call it life. That's why they call it gardening. See you next time. Boom.